Social networking has changed the way many of us communicate, but it has also created a new frontier for gathering personal information.
And sometimes that information is ending up in the courts in both civil and criminal cases. WLKY Steve Bergen has been investigating. He joins us now with what he's discovered. Steve?
Right, Vicki, it has created a greater connection among people and businesses, but what's posted on social websites can be both helpful and hurtful. In many cases, it's the first place law enforcement turns to.
Anytime you come close to a courthouse, everything becomes fair game. Everything.
As an attorney and instructor at the University of Louisville, Michael LoSavio has studied the pros and cons of social media when it comes to law enforcement. He cites the Boston Marathon bombing. After the deadly attack, the FBI posted photos of the bombing suspects, but on several occasions, the finger was pointed at the wrong person.
There was bad information that got put out there, and they start, you know, accusing people that had nothing to do with this. If people make an accusation, they remember the accusation. They don't remember when they say, oh, we were wrong, sorry.
In Lexington, social media was successfully used after fires erupted following Kentucky's win over Louisville in the 2012 Final Four. Photos and videos posted online led to charges.
Social media have changed the evidence gathering, investigative and intelligence activities of law enforcement.
More of what is discovered on social networking sites is ending up in the courts. Case in point, the sexual assault of 17-year-old Savannah Dietrich. The uproar began when Dietrich tweeted about confidential juvenile proceedings regarding the two teenage boys charged. There were also incriminating text messages that became part of the court file.
And there were things that were said on there which were material to the prosecution.
Social media has provided a new avenue to hurt people.
On the upside, cyber sleuthing by government agencies led the FBI to bust an alleged billion-dollar underground website called Silk Road. Its creator used what's called an onion wrap to allegedly deal in drugs, guns, and phony documents. Transactions were encrypted and bounced from server to server. Last month, Ross Ulbricht, identified as the mastermind, was arrested in the science fiction section of this San Francisco library. But LoSavio and others believe there must be guidelines. He cites the ongoing data collection on U.S. citizens by the National Security Agency.
This incredible power to monitor people's lives must be used appropriately.
A private eye with more than 30 years of law enforcement experience calls social media sites a treasure trove of information. You'll hear from him tomorrow night at 6. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.